Hi guys, André Tétrault, Director of Test and Diagnostics here at Vibra System. The subject for today is axial displacement. Axial displacement is quite often considered an afterthought. I've been involved in quite a few projects where the axial displacement probe was supplied simply to fill in the last slot in a 16 or a 32 channel monitoring system. But in reality, I've been involved in quite a few cases where the data from the axial displacement was pivotal to determine the source of an issue. The first case that comes to mind is in Brazil in a horizontal or bulb type unit where the actual movement is critical to them. And in reality, I destroyed two probes before I figured out that the axial displacement was much greater than what the unit was designed for. So it allowed them to intervene and correct the issue. Second one was in Canada quite a few years ago on a vertical generator. After a major overhaul because of a thrust guide bearing failure, the utility and the manufacturer worked very hard to put the unit back in service. A monitoring system was installed and it included an axial displacement probe. And what that probe showed is that as they increased the load, the unit was being dragged downwards at a much greater degree than what the thrust guide bearing was designed to support. Evidently, that would have caused a second major thrust guide bearing failure eventually. So to be able to monitor that, we use capacitive displacement probes. So thank you for listening in, and please comment if you have any questions.